So I just installed Blender 2.79 and I want to show you some of my base settings. So first of all, I turn on zoom to position and rotate around selection under interface. So what this does is whatever you have selected, it'll rotate around the selection. And zoom to mouse location is basically wherever the mouse is, you will zoom to that location. And then under editing, I increase my undos to something like 99. And in under transform, I enable release confirms. Release confirms is basically if you have it disabled and you move a component or an object, when you release your left mouse button or right mouse button, it will still stick to the mouse, to the cursor. And then you have to click again and then it will release. So with this option selected, the moment you release your mouse button, it will confirm the edit. And this, like I said, this is for components or for the object. So I turn this on. And then when it's turned on, you, like I said, you just have to drag, release, and it immediately applies the change. So then under input, there's a few things. I turn on continuous grab, and what that does is without continuous grab, you can basically only move something as far as your screen allows you to move your cursor or your mouse. And with continuous grab turned on, it loops the mouse over the width or length of the screen, so you can continuously, infinitely move stuff. And this applies to menus as well as like sliders and stuff like that, as well as actual stuff. So then drag threshold and tweak threshold is kind of like how long it takes or how far you have to move your mouse before it starts dragging a component or a menu item. And it's dependent kind of on the screen resolution and stuff like that. So then there's select with left and right, and I do select left. By default it's select right in Blender, but selecting with the left mouse button is kind of more universal, and that's what I'm used to, so I do select left. Let's see, so then I keep invert mouse by default. Then I think that's it for input. Let's see, so then add-ons, I will go over that in another video. Themes, I usually mess around with that for a bit, and once in a while I change it. Graph is a good one, I think. The only thing I do is I turn off gradient and then I drag one color to another color input, which you can do in Blender, to make the 3D view background dark. And save user settings. So then under file, I change the temp folder to something that I can remember. I'll do that later. And then I increase my save versions a bit, just for safety. And then under system, right, so there is the properties and tool shelf. And what you can do is you can, when you turn on region overlap, it basically makes those two shelves transparent. And you can, it kind of expands the area of your 3D view. I don't know how beneficial this is, but I kind of like it. And I think that's probably about it.